Tuesday, January 9th. Unexpected news. Just another Tuesday. I'm sitting at work, Jerry.
This is how we do Tuesdays. It's just another Tuesday.
Just another Tuesday. And I come across my phone, an announcement. And you know, got to realize, since the strikes, we haven't got anything. Well, everyone after the strikes, and the strikes happened, everyone was dropping their stuff, right? We got trailers that day. We got script ideas.
Star Wars has been talking about, we've been talking about the Rey movie. We're like, okay, Rey movie. Incels mad, men who hate women, completely angry. And this out of the blue,
left, right hook. We were knocked out. So, yes, we're talking about the announcement today, and I'll read the StarWars.com article just so everyone gets caught up. The Mandalorian and Grogu journeys to the big screen. Now, we had heard rumors that there was going to be a season 4. We knew that, right? And so when that tweet came across my phone, they were like, Filoni's working on a movie. We have no idea what the context of that movie is going to be. And then all of a sudden, we thought the Rey movie was coming first. And you're right. Left, right, hook. And we're here. So,
boom.
I was so excited to get this. And we'll talk about some of the discourse that happened today after. We'll talk about that. But I'm going to finish reading the article. It says, The Mandalorian and Grogu are embarking on a new adventure to movie theaters. Directed by Jon Favreau and produced by Favreau, Kathleen Kennedy, and Dave Filoni, The Mandalorian and Grogu will go into production in 2024. That's the title. The Mandalorian and Grogu. I missed that the first time.
Yeah,
I have loved telling stories set in a rich world that George Lucas created, said Favreau. The prospect of bringing the Mandalorian and his apprentice Grogu to the big screen is extremely exciting. Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni will usher into Star Wars two new beloved characters, and this new story is a perfect fit for the big screen, added Kathleen Kennedy, president of Lucasfilm. I'm sorry, for those that don't know that. The Mandalorian and Grogu will lead Lucasfilm's ongoing feature development slate, including films held by Shireen Aboy-Chinoy, James Mangold, and Dave Filoni, who is currently developing Ahsoka Season 2 among those in the works. So, left, right, hook, this is the fourth movie now on the slate, if I'm reading that correctly. Because Favreau's directing this one. Dave's doing his own movie. We've got the Shireen movie with Rey, and then we got James Mangold's movie. Yeah, Shireen, yeah. So, here we are. How did you react first? What was your like initial thoughts?
Well, I came back from one of my from the line to my break at work and everything, because I work at a factory still and everything. And like you guys are like boom, 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 boom,
blowing you up. I know.
And I was like, okay, there's a new movie. Oh, this is the, and I was I think I was at first just like, oh, cool, it's details on the Filoni ending the thing, and was like, wait, hold on. Hold the phone. Favreau is coming in to direct this. And honestly, bold choice to do it as a sequel to Elf.
Yes.
I just thought I thought that was a bold move. You know,
wild,
to have them going to Tatooine by way of the Candy Cane Forest, the sea of swirly twirly gumdrops. It's going to be great.
But it's funny you bring that up. I love it. Let's talk about Favreau for a second. One of my favorite episodes of The Mandalorian is The Marshal, which I still credit to be one of the best episodes in the whole series because of three things.
Top to bottom.
The inclusion of Cobb Vanth. He did not have to do that. The inclusion of the Krayt Dragon, but the aspect ratio change that changed my life. I did not realize that was God tier.
That's pure sex every time.
Yes, every time.
The screen goes up and everything, you know?
I felt like I was in IMAX theater. Ready. That and the third and final part, the returnable effect in that aspect and that idea. So he knows what universe he's playing in. We know what he likes to write. We know what he likes to do. So the fact that he's going to direct this movie, because the Krayt Dragon scene still to this day holds up so well. And that came out 4 years ago now. So
there's no way it came out 4 years ago.
Yeah, dude. It'll be 4 years in October. God, 4 years in October.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. It's one of the best. It's one of the best episodes. I'm with you. It's one of the best episodes we've ever gotten.
I want to go rewatch it after this because
it
holds up so well.
I don't know why more films don't take that. And maybe they do, and I just don't notice it. But like the slow removal of the bars is how you should do every scene that changes to IMAX instead of.
Yes.
Have you ever been watching an IMAX enhanced version and it just goes from this to this?
This? Yeah.
Like, whoa, we're big and wide now.
Yeah.
It slaps you in the face and it makes it. Yeah. But if you have a nice, like, oh, we're doing some foreplay now. Here we go. Oh,
yes.
A bigger. Yeah, because baby.
Jaws is a, no, sorry, not Jaws. Jurassic Park is a great example of that. The whole movie shot in IMAX ratio. So like when you watch it, like that's why everything feels so big. And that's why when Favreau did it, this thing's coming out the cave and it gets huge. And you're like, now my whole screen's filled up because your eyes get so focused. And you know, and you got to think too, it's Favreau. You never know what this movie could have in store. Are you worried about the fate of our characters? Because I don't think I am. I think we're going to be okay.
Not really. And I had someone, I saw someone posted this quote earlier about what George told Dave as he left, like, you know, make these stories for the kids and make them hopeful because they need that.
Yeah.
It's not the exact quote, but like just a paraphrase. And so, sure. I mean, do I think there will be stakes and consequence? Absolutely. But again, I think it's going to be a fun adventure. And honestly, if anything, like there's been a trend recently with movies that you can take a character and drag them through hell and still give them a happy ending.
Yeah.
And if you earn that, like we've had like what?
Godzilla Minus One,
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3.
Yes.
I just rewatched this yesterday actually.
Yeah,
bawled my eyes out. But of course. But you know, I think we're to a point as a society where we like, you know, most people are like, oh, who's gonna die? That's the stakes. Is if always. Someone can die, and sometimes the stakes can be emotional. Sometimes the stakes can be, you know, like how are we ever? I don't know. I think we can have this adventure, and I guess this is my long-winded version of saying, I think that they're fine.
Yeah.
I think that the Mandalorian and Grogu, Din and Grogu, are going to be a family at the end of the day.
Yes. And
who
I
else
think
is part of that family and still there is up in the air.
Of course. And we know the most recent season of Mandalorian became very Mandalorian heavy. We got a lot more lore about these characters. They went back to Mandalore, and like I can't exactly show it here because I didn't have it prepared, but like I made a sheet of characters that are in the universe right now, and I'll show it on screen for anyone watching, but I'll list them. You got both. You got starting off Grogu, Din Djarin, the Mandalorian, Cobb Vanth, R5, Bo-Katan, Axe Woves, Mercedes Vardanos character. I forget her name. What's her name, Jerry? Mercedes. Hold on. God. I know. That's okay.
We are great Star Wars commentators.
Okay, you got Boba Fett, Fennec Shan, Pelimoto, you got Bill Burr's character, you got the twins, you've got Chrysanthemum, you've got Luke, you've got the armorer, you've got the Major Domo, you've got
Major Domo?
Yeah, there's no name for him yet. Still Major Domo. You've got the other biker chick, what was her name?
Trash.
Remember her name. Okay. You've also still got in this universe, you've got the Tusken Raider that we didn't see in the pile of bodies, the really cool lady one.
Yes.
You've got Michael was going off about her earlier. Elia Kane. You've also got Dr. Pershing. You've got Pelion. Now you have Thrawn in this area. You've got Greef Karga, Hera, Ezra, and the Night Sister Witches, all three of them. So you've got so many characters to play with now. They'll probably introduce us to some new ones as well. But like, there are characters that can really play a role because we know Ahsoka and Sabine, and of course Baylan Skoll and good lord, I'm having a blank today, man. We didn't expect to do this tonight. They're off in the Peridia, the different galaxy.
Peridia,
so
that's the one.
Yeah. So I got that. No, but you've got all these characters you can play with in this sandbox, and you know, they're gonna get clicks. They're gonna want to put Boba Fett in the poster. They're gonna want to put Cobb Vanth. Like, you you can have a huge star-studded cast and have them just play small roles. And this might be just like a really long episode of The Mandalorian, or this could be very segmented. I don't know. I'm so curious to see how they write this. And the title alone gets me so excited. The Mandalorian and Grogu. So you don't have to do the Baby Yoda thing anymore. People should know this now.
Right.
It's going to be in the cultural zeitgeist. I still got students that are like, the Baby Yoda?
Baby Yoda. Eleanor, my daughter will still sometimes call him Baby Yoda and stuff like that. It's in the zeitgeist and stuff like, but maybe like, yeah, after this movie, it'll be like, oh, that's Din Grogu and stuff.
Yep.
That's the thing. They didn't put his Christian name on the poster. You know?
So the Mandalorian,
just Grogu. It's Din Grogu.
That's true. He does take the first name. That's true. Man, nothing makes me more excited than the idea of being back on the big screen. And you know how fast the turnaround is on these seasons of The Mandalorian. They film it and edit it all within like 7 or 8 months. So we could get this movie like relatively soon, sooner than we think.
Yeah.
I'm still thinking December of 2025. That's my gut feeling. There was no date. There was no date attached to this press release.
2025 is pretty safe, especially if they're filming this year. I mean, we don't know how much pre-production they already have done.
No.
Right. Like they had this announcement ready. I think this has been ready to go for a while.
Yes.
Didn't Favreau say, someone was saying Favreau had season 4 ready to go.
Yeah.
Everything already.
Yeah.
And so maybe they're just saying, hey, let's adapt this into a couple of films or this. It could be. And this is just the first. It doesn't necessarily. And I like the friend of the show, frenemy of the show, Jared the Dark Jedi. I was talking about this could just be the beginning, you know?
Yes.
Like that's the exciting part of it.
Dude. And Favreau helmed Iron Man.
I love that.
He helmed Iron Man in 2008, and look at what it spawned.
Oh, yeah.
Like, seriously. Like, it's so exciting. And, like, story they wrote fits it, then great. Do it. You know what I mean? And they could drop.
Oh, absolutely.
They could seriously drop something crazy, like, oh, we're going back to a May release, or we're going to go. Like, they have so much they can do now that we're 5 years disconnected from movies releasing. So this movie might come out this year.
Wild.
We don't know. We don't know how far in production they are. If they've announced it, that means the concept art phase is done. They might be shooting soon. You know what I mean? Which I'm sure we'll get that in the next couple of weeks. But, man.
Oh, we'll be seeing some stuff. Yeah.
So when the day we're recording this, we dropped our first podcast episode, and by tomorrow we're going to have a whole nother special. And we were talking about hyping up, you know, the future of Star Wars. And again, not on our bingo cards. We've got
no,
who would have thought?
No one knew. We did not know that this was coming. I mean, also upon recording this, there are whispers on Jennifer Corbett of the Bad Batch fame was teasing people because Bad Batch has been trending. I don't know if you saw this because I know you were walking before this, but Jennifer Corbett said, "Was it? Oh, Bad Batch is trending. Y'all must really want that trailer, huh?" And with a GIF of someone cooking. So we've got that imminent. We've got the Mandalorian and Grogu feature film announced for theaters. It's kind of crazy. Ghostbusters, Frozen Empire has been moved up a week. 2024 is looking great, friends. Yes, yeah, it got bumped. They bumped that thing up a week.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Well, it's
in
the same month as Dune. So there, it's going to be a hell of a month, man. We're going to be in the theaters a lot.
Oh, man. I think it's dropping the same day. It's dropping the same day as something huge on the 22nd. The 22nd of March. I forget what. It was sharing. I think
Dune's
it with,
the first but. Week. Dune's like the first week. But still, though, how exciting is this? Because we'll be getting new Star Wars probably in the same exact time. I don't know. This is the thing. We go through cycles of nothing. The writer's strike was proof that we got nothing except Ahsoka, which was amazing. But the writer's strike, we couldn't talk about anything that people that are in the royal eye. yes, the royal we. They couldn't talk about it. They couldn't do anything about it. And then all of a sudden, there's going to be a flurry of shit that's going to be coming out. And I'm, what an exciting time, man. Yeah, I'm pumped for this. They actually, they showed a piece of concept art that I have right here. It's not so good, but that it is flying away. It's them flying away from a ship. So if you haven't pulled it up, go pull it up yet. It's them.
Yeah, go pull flying it up. Away. Whose bed have those boots been under is the question on everybody's mind today, actually.
And like, I can only imagine they're definitely in the concept art phase, probably past that. They're probably well into other parts of development. So I don't know, man. This excites me. I love that this came out of nowhere, and I'm really looking forward to, you know, what comes next and what other news we're going to get, because, I mean, it doesn't stop. It never stops.
It never stops.
So one thing I want to address before we kind of end this thing, there was a lot of discourse that came out of this release. And just like most Star Wars fans or most people that love Star Wars, there's always going to be like some interesting fluxes of thoughts and beliefs. And a lot of people, the big takes I saw, which I think to me, I don't find it to be that convincing, is that streaming is failing. That was one of the takes I saw, which I don't, how do you feel about that? Cause I don't think that's the case at all.
I think there's a little bit to the fact that I don't think that they're going to stop streaming, obviously, because they still have streaming series coming out. That's still a big part of the game. But I definitely think that like, I mean, Marvel is starting to kind of turn back into movies and stuff like that, you know, a little bit, but the medium is still there. I don't think that it's going away. I think that they're course correcting naturally. Most of both of these huge studios and going like for Star Wars, like that's, movies have always been their bread and butter and they've been streaming for the last several years. So now they're like, no, okay, we're going to have the streaming stuff. That's still going on. But you're about to have movies, more movies than you know what to do with. Mm-hmm. And that's exciting. That's what that's how you get the fans excited. And so is it like trumpeting the failure of the streaming? And I don't think so personally.
No, not at all.
Because I think the numbers are still up despite what a lot of people are saying. Like, you know, there was a lot of people saying that, like, oh, Mando season 3 wasn't that great. Ahsoka was somehow divided, which again, like, I don't want to like poo-poo anyone or anything like that, but it just some Star Wars stuff works for not every Star Wars thing is going to work for everybody.
Yeah.
And that's fine. And that's natural. That's that's how it's supposed to be. So
of course. And that's
people are very precious with this franchise, so we want to put like a feeling behind it and say, like, oh, they learned their lesson. There you go. It's like a sports, it's your favorite sports team, but we don't do sports because we're nerds.
Yes. So. But I do think it's important too to address the fact that this being a movie shows that they want to grow beyond just a streaming platform. And my only thing, my only complaint in this capacity is I feel bad for people that have not got caught up with The Mandalorian and the Book of Boba Fett and Ahsoka, because a lot of the events that take place probably that, you know, lead from one of those shows into the other are going to be a heavy part of this series. So either there's going to be a damn good recap before the movie, or the trailer's going to act as a recap and a tease. I'm just
honestly,
curious.
Honestly, you got a whole year to subscribe to Disney Plus.
Yeah, you do.
Check it out. Yep. And just kind of power through. And honestly, it's an easy watch. It's a fun watch. I mean,
some of the best Star Wars.
You're a Star Wars fan. My parents are very casual fans and stuff like that. You know, like I wouldn't even use the word fans. They love the Mandalorian. They think it's great. They're like, oh, this is great. This is just like the old movies. It's great.
You know,
it's fun. It's fun. Just get on it if you haven't got on it yet. Now's your excuse.
Definitely. And it's funny too. This is the first Disney film release that isn't reliant on typical Star Wars things. So, like, I'm sure there'll be stormtroopers. I'm sure there'll be X-Wings. What I mean sincerely is that since the release of all the sequel trilogy, Solo and Rogue One, all those movies have relied heavily on legacy characters or events from legacy movies, like Rogue One, for example, the Death Star, and characters that are legacy. This is the first show, or I guess movie now, that is reliant on itself. If you have watched the shows on Disney Plus, you will be in a good space to see the movie. So it's weird. It's kind of like it's going to be more than likely, if we think about the math of it, if it comes out in December, you're looking at 6 years since Disney Plus launched. You know what I mean? Which is so surreal to say. So yeah. 2019, yeah. So, I mean, if it comes up this year, it very well could. It'll be 5 years since Disney Plus launched with The Mandalorian. So people that may complain, oh, I can't believe I got to watch this, but it sounds so douchey. You've had 5 years to kind of, just like you followed the prequel trilogy or the sequel trilogy.
Honestly, and you don't even have to watch the prequel trilogy again. Just watch Obi-Wan Kenobi, and it has a great recap in front of it.
Yes.
Honestly, it's so much easier than the Marvel shows. You can get caught up so easy on the Star Wars stuff. It's just watch it in the order it was released, and you are going to be fine, Francine. Sad. I promise. You're going to be okay.
But it's true. I didn't see any discourse about that. I didn't see... I did see discourse about how it's not Dave's not really involved, but he definitely is. He's an executive producer, so his name stands
involved. I mean, producer credit I know can be like anything from you loaned a pack of gum to the production.
Yes.
And that's a very small anyway.
Yes.
It could be ornamental, or it can be like you actually did a whole hell of a lot to
of get course.
This thing off the ground, and so. I realize that people like look at the producer credit if you're and act like, oh, I'm in the know. That don't mean shit. It could mean shit, though. And with Filoni being in charge of a lot of things, being promoted at Lucasfilm now, I mean, I think he's involved.
Yes. These are also his
finger
characters.
In that pie. He's got his finger in that pie. Yeah.
This is his characters. This is his lore. He launched the show back when Disney Plus started with the first episode, and now he's getting his own movie. And Favreau's carrying on the torch of something he's been writing now for since 2017. That's when Grogu was pitched, November of 17. So it's gonna be like for real, almost like 8 years till that character comes to fruition on the big screen. Which is that's the crazy part to say. So I'm so excited. This may even tie into Skeleton Crew. Those characters might have their start in this movie or a climate. Like I love the fact that they can play in this universe and have it be very interconnected. And people are like the Marvel at all. But the thing with Marvel is there's already so much like comic baggage there, you know? There's already things that you can get, you know, I can't think of it, like reference material, right? Whereas with this, it's uncharted territory. That's why I love The Mandalorian. Every episode feels like we're in a whole different area because we don't know where they end up. We don't. And like Andor, great. I know where Andor ends up, and he's dead because of a sacrifice he made. You know, I watched Solo.
It's a great
I know
journey.
Where he ends up. He's dead because of a sacrifice he made. You know, this is the first show that's like, where are we going? And I never would have thought we would go to a different galaxy in Ahsoka. No.
I mean,
it's amazing.
You don't have to, Star Wars, we don't have to constantly sacrifice characters.
Nope, we don't.
Some of them can just be cool and exist.
Yes.
And everything, you know? That's perfectly fine.
It's perfectly fine. And my last...
Give us another... I think we've come back around to another fairy tale ending.
Yes,
agree. You know how the original trilogy ended with a fairy tale ending? I think we've earned ourselves another fairy tale ending. So
yes. And not even an ending. In the most part, this is a fairy tale completion. It's something
just like the continuation of these adventures, the adventures of these characters, right? That's what you love to see. And again, not that there can't be stakes or anything like that. But anyway,
I want to say one last thing before we sign this whole thing off. I've not seen this yet. I haven't been scrolling through my phone that much today, but for budgetary reasons, this is the best move because now you can make a huge budget movie because for those that don't know, every episode of The Mandalorian is about 40 minutes. It's always about a $10 million budget. That's always the budget for each show. Now you've got a lot of people backing this up. Disney's going to market the piss out of this movie. We're going to get so much Grogu and Din stuff. I hope there's a Pepsi can line. I hope there's like a whole Taco Bell. You know, like
if I could go buy a what is it called now? Starry, a can of Starry with Pelimoto on it, I will die happy. Are you kidding me right there?
That's the thing.
Carry me with that can.
They have so many characters built up that like it wouldn't be a risk. Who doesn't want to go to McDonald's and get a Grogu toy? You know what I mean? Who doesn't want to get a Mandalorian toy?
Oh, man. Like, market movies like it's the 90s again, Movies like that again now. Like, I know, cost-effective, blah, 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 COVID and all that. Make this the one where comes, but, like, man, until we can kill the dragon that is – what am I even trying to say? Until we can kill consumerism and things like that, like – listen, we're capitalists. Just not us, but like the society is capitalist. Feed us. We must live in it. So just go ahead and give us this kind of shit. So the
Grogu toothpaste.
Yeah.
You know,
shit that out of the dragon. Shit that out.
Dude. And it's so easy. Give me Grogu, you know, underwear. I know they already have it, but like when this movie's coming out, I want to be pissed off. That's how much Grogu I want. I want to be like turn
a damn corner without seeing Grogu's adorable mug all over a mug.
I remember when the Avengers movies were coming out in like 2012, and there was Avengers canned Coke, and it was everywhere. There was Avengers stuff, the 2012 Avengers everywhere, and like that's the last time I felt
today.
Like,
we've got Madam Web Ocean Spray.
Yes, damn it!
You're doing it for Madam Web. Come on,
dude! I want to see like. Crying out loud. Crazy. Cars with wraps outside the theater, just like Grogu wraps. Like, and you know what? You know what I mean? Like, I just want I want to be overwhelmed, and I want Grogu's people to be like
in the back of every car, like
yes,
hand on the glass and shit.
Oh, the dream! Yeah, man. I know we have our thoughts, we have our takes, and I know we have our beliefs, but this is a great step in the right direction. Like, seriously,
it's exciting that it's so close. It's getting closer.
It's weird. And like
this year is going to be kind of fun. It's going to be a ramp up for things because like there's a lot of there's a lot of Star Wars things coming out. There's a lot of good pop culture stuff that's coming out too that is just so exciting. And so
which we'll cover.
It's going to be we are going to be covering.
We're going to cover that. Absolutely. That's right. 100% cover
pop culture.
Pop culture. No.
Pop culture.
On a scale from 1 to 10, I'm 10. I cannot wait. I cannot wait to be in the theater again. God bless. We're going to have to, I'm going to have to fly and see it with you. We're going to have to work something out.
Yes, please do. Okay. We're making plans right now. You're flying up to see it with me. Okay.
Cause it'd be us flying down or
something.
Oh,
that's what we could do is we could all convene. We could go see it together in a nice comfy theater and have a pint.
Well, they've got it figured out too. Let's discuss this for 2 seconds. The next celebration is in 2025. It's in Japan. What a better place to launch it, right? April of 2025. Yeah. The first like big trailer, maybe not the teaser, but the first big trailer comes out, holds us out until December of 2025, and here we are. The Din and Grogu movie. Like, oh my God, I can't believe it. We're getting a Mandalorian movie. Like, I can't wait to be in the theater crying with popcorn in my hand again. I want to watch trailers again. It felt so long since we've had like an epic movie. Oh, yeah. God.
We're back, kids. We're back. We're back. We're in this. We're in the ramp up to the new slate of Star Wars films. Star Wars films. And that it feels good to say. And I'm so glad that we were able to get on a mic and just kind of hash this out a little bit tonight.
Yeah, I agree, man.
Oh man.
I love this. I love you. This is so much fun.
I love you. I love you guys watching and listening, whatever you're doing. We love you all. And we're back, baby. We're back, baby.
All right, everyone.
Whose bed has Din's boots been under?
She's a good singer. He's got a great voice.
Is it Bo-Katan? It's Bo-Katan.
Or that
now.
That lady from what planet was it?
I know what you're talking about. The fishery planet.
Yes.
The one where they make alcohol out of fish.
Yes.
You remember that's what those things were for.
I can tell you who's not coming back. Gina Carina, am I right? How are we doing?
What if Gina Carina? What if like
this they is a have comeback
completely
kid?
Recast her. They have completely recast her, and it is just like it's someone like it's fucking Brie Larson or something.
Yeah. Oh my God, Jerry!
Fucking awesome would that be?
People would be like furious.
Well, you know, you got that strand cast shit done to your face. It's good to see you. Good to see you again. Yeah, I've been healing up, and you know what? I am 99.9% less of an asshole. No.
There you go. Perfect.
That's my. Here we go.
Hope you enjoyed this brief special from the Bombad Cast. And Jerry, what should everyone do?
Well, follow us on all our social medias and all that kind of stuff. But follow Scotty at the Scott Jero. Follow me at the Cannon Junkie. Follow Bombadcast at Bombadcast.
Yes.
And
watch Ionized Bastards.
Well, not just that, but love the skin you're in. Love yourself. Love that we're in this again. Look, you can look fine. You don't like the title, but you're still going to go watch it. We know you're going to go watch it. You're going to go watch it. You know, just give them the money right now. We know you're going to go watch it. It's fine. No one believes this for a second, and I know you don't either. So we'll see you in the cinema. And until then, stay bombed!